first, good morning. Thank you for taking the time to speak with me. So I'm a huge fan of Manifest. Been watching since day one, so love the show. So first and foremost, one of the things that really drew me to the show is not only kind of the sci-fi feel of, you know, trying to understand what happened to this plane, but one of the cool things that they talk about is kind of the family drama. How does the family deal with losing their loved ones for 5 years, and how do you kind of pick up, you know, once, you know, everyone meets back up? And so I want to know, what drew you to this project and your characters?
Well, just as you said, actually, the family drama is the thing that drew me the most. I mean, I think the supernatural mystery is really cool, but what grounds the show and what gives the show legs, I think, is the real issues that this family has to deal with that could, you know, could parallel other people's real issues in real life and makes it relatable. And I think it's crazy, like, it, you know, imagine that, having gone through 5.5 years of pain and grief and healing, and then suddenly, you know, boom, these people are back in your life and picking up from that and going forward. So I think that, I mean, it's just, it's a really a lot of fun to explore as an actor, and I mean, hopefully it's great for audiences as well.
No, I mean, I agree. I think, you know, what's so interesting about it is the idea of a second chance and the idea of an interrupted life, but there's no blame. You can't blame people for the actions that they've taken while 5.5 years have passed. You know, life starts to move on. So their lives are, in a sense, interrupted again. And it's about how they deal with that and how they go forward. And in terms of, you know, Ben and Grace, I think they're really trying to find each other again, and they're trying to find each other in this whole mess, and hopefully they can. You know, I think all the characters are just trying to find out where they fit in this world that looks exactly the same, but is very, very different.
So I really want to know, like, on the outside looking in, you know, how do you feel? Do you feel as though that you would react the same way that your characters did to these circumstances?
No, I don't feel like I would react the same way Vinsta. I think I would probably be, you know, locked up in an institution and I couldn't speak. I would be probably rocking back and forth in fetal position. You know, Ben Stone has such a level head, and he's very tenacious, but I don't think I would be as adept in this situation as he is.
I also do not think, I think Grace Stone is way more patient and understanding and open than I would also be freaking out.
Yeah.
Not dealing with it as calmly as she is.
So can you talk more kind of what your characters are going to go through for the rest of the season? Because it's been a lot of back and forth.
Yes.
I mean, you're out of the house, you're back in the house. You know, how kind of the family unit, you know, are we going to see more of how you guys come together?
I mean, I think we will definitely see more of the Stones coming back together. And we're already starting to see that. How long it lasts, I'm not for sure. If it's successful, I'm not for sure. But they're trying. You know, I think they all, you know, Grace and Ben have a deep love for each other. And I think they're really trying to get their heads around it and trying to work it out. And I think Ben's problem is that he's been trying to recreate what he had, you know, 5.5 years ago, but for him it hasn't been 5.5 years ago. And of course for Grace it's moved on, so they're in two different places. And I think they're just trying to find a middle ground where they can meet up again. And I think that they're working their way towards that, I think.
I'm rooting for you guys, okay?
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So I have to ask everyone this question. After doing the show, how do you feel about flying now?
I mean, I think about it. I think about something weird happening every time I'm on a flight. I don't know, but
you don't. No, hasn't.
That's the best way to be.
Never,
like, that's fiction.
Right.
This is real life.
Right. Oh, right.
I mean, I don't like turbulence because it makes me nauseous, but not because I'm afraid I will crash.
Or not because
you're disappear
fearful.
For 5 years.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me today. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.